Do your feet hurt, specifically in the heel or arch area of your feet? Or have you been told that you have plantar fasciitis? And are you frustrated that your pain will not go away despite following your doctor's recommendations of wearing supportive shoes, completing exercises and stretches, or even limiting certain physical activities? Well, what if your doctor doesn't know how to fix your plantar fasciitis, all because maybe they don't know the true cause of your plantar fasciitis? Hi, I'm Sean Daniel of Foot Truth, and the reason I ask such a bold question like that is because of two contrasting factors. One, today in 2021, there is no shortage of information and research available regarding plantar fasciitis. And also in today's age, shoe companies are supposedly making the most technologically advanced and research-backed footwear. Now, secondly, despite these things that I just mentioned, there are still about 3 million plantar fasciitis cases each year just in the United States. And between $192 million and $376 million is estimated to be spent each year treating plantar fasciitis. If doctors and shoe companies discovered and made available the true solution for plantar fasciitis, why would there be so many cases every year, and why would loads of money continually be spent on treating this foot problem? In this first video in my three-part series on plantar fasciitis, we're going to discover why your doctor might not know how to fix your plantar fasciitis. First, let's figure out what plantar fasciitis actually is. Now, the suffix of itis, I-T-I-S, in plantar fasciitis means inflammation. Therefore, plantar fasciitis means inflammation of the plantar fascia. And your plantar fascia is the thick band of tissue that runs across the bottom of your foot and connects your heel bone to your toes. According to the Mayo Clinic, which is one of the biggest medical organizations in the world, quote, plantar fasciitis is one of the most common causes of heel pain. They continue to say, plantar fasciitis commonly causes stabbing pain that usually occurs with your first steps in the morning. And as you get up and move, the pain normally decreases, but it might return after long periods of standing or when you stand up after sitting. If this sounds like the pain you're experiencing, then according to the Mayo Clinic and many other websites and doctors, you may have plantar fasciitis. And in order to get rid of your plantar fasciitis, you must learn what is truly causing it. So what is the cause of plantar fasciitis? Unfortunately, the Mayo Clinic's website and many other websites and doctors list many possible causes of plantar fasciitis, ranging from tight calf muscles to being overweight to even not wearing supportive shoes. But the Mayo Clinic's website also says, quote, the cause remains unclear in many cases of plantar fasciitis. And this information is coming from the Mayo Clinic, which is one of the biggest medical organizations in the world. They employ almost 60,000 staff members, over 4,500 of which are physicians and scientists, and they spend over $660 million a year on research. Yet despite their huge staff and the heaps of research they do each year, the Mayo Clinic still says on their website, quote, the cause remains unclear in many cases of plantar fasciitis. And since there's so many plantar fasciitis cases each year, and so much money is spent treating it each year, obviously our medical professionals and shoe companies are not doing a good job of identifying and eliminating the main cause or causes of plantar fasciitis. But despite this lack of assuredness on the true causes, what does the Mayo Clinic, along with many doctors and podiatrists, prescribe as possible solutions for plantar fasciitis? Well, it's an extremely long list that ranges from icing to wearing braces and even to shockwave therapy. And if I had plantar fasciitis like I did a few years ago, I'd be overwhelmed and wouldn't know which possible solution to try first. Unfortunately, since the Mayo Clinic and doctors list so many possible solutions for plantar fasciitis, it only proves that, quote, the cause remains unclear in many cases of plantar fasciitis. Now let's say you tried every single one of these solutions, but despite your efforts, your plantar fasciitis pain just will not go away. Well, don't worry, because then some doctors and podiatrists may recommend one of two surgeries, the gastrocnemius recession surgery or the plantar fascia release surgery. In both of these surgeries, a natural part of your body, your calf tendon or your plantar fascia, will be cut and it will never be the same. And that would be done all in the hopes of possibly eradicating your plantar fascia pain. And these parts of your body could be cut all with your doctor and surgeon being just like the Mayo Clinic, or they might not know the true cause of your plantar fasciitis. So really, they could be guessing about whether or not those permanent and expensive surgeries will actually solve your plantar fasciitis and get rid of your pain. I say that because if any of these possible solutions, even the surgeries, truly solved plantar fasciitis and removed the true causes of it, why would there be more than 3 million cases of it in the United States each year? And if those were true solutions, why would between $192 million and $376 million be spent each year treating plantar fasciitis? Well, in 2003, Temple University podiatrist Dr. Harvey Lamont asked a similar question and discovered a remarkable truth. And in the second video of my three-part series on plantar fasciitis, we'll learn how Dr. Lamont discovered the unknown and yet major cause of plantar fasciitis. If you want to see that video, be sure to subscribe. But once it's uploaded, I'll link that video up above and in the description below. And if you like this video, be sure to hit that thumbs up button and see if we can reach 1,000 likes. Again, I'm Sean Daniel of Foot Truth. Thank you for watching.